Let's get started. Where are we studying? We're starting to look at functions and models. In terms of functions and models, we're saying the idea of a function is one of the most important concepts in mathematics. Put simply, a function is a special kind of correspondence between the two sets. Let's look at the following. To each letter on a telephone keypad, there corresponds a number. To each model of a cell phone in a store, it goes hand in hand with its price. To each real number, there corresponds the cube of that number. Now, what is a function? See, a function is a correspondence between a first set called the domain and a second set called the range, such that each member of the domain corresponds to exactly one member of the range. For example, 'talking about the domain and the range, in this case, we are looking about the squares of the numbers. In this case, 2 squared has got its range being 4. The same applies to 3, which is the domain, has got its range being 9, 4, corresponding to the range, which is 16, 5, corresponding to 25. Most functions considered in mathematics are described by an equation. To graph the function, y equals to 2x plus 3. We find ordered pairs by performing calculations for selected x values. This is what we did at the beginning, early in high school, when we began to plot functions. For example, in this case, we say for x equals to 4, we'll take that value of x, we'll put it in the place of x in the given function, then solve, get the corresponding y value. In this case, when we take x and then we put it in y equals to 2x plus 3, we end up having 11. Do we agree that when we put 4 in the place of x in y equals to 2x plus 3, we get 11?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Now, when we put negative 5 in the place of x in y equals to 2x plus 3, we get negative 7. Do we agree?
Yes, we agree, sir.
Then when we put 0 in the place of x, our corresponding y value is 3. Please do this for me. Do you see this exercise? Y equals to 4 minus x squared.
Yes.
Please put 4 in the place of x and tell me what you get as the corresponding y value.
Negative 12.
Please ask them whether they agree with you or not.
Do you guys agree?
Yes, that's correct.
Well, I agree.
Thank you,
Platelo. Someone said that's correct. Who's that?
It was me, sir.
Who?
Mahadi.
Mahadi?
Yes. Okay.
Please help us out here. For x equals to negative 5, what will be the corresponding y value?
Negative 21. Wait, is it negative? Negative 21.
Yes, negative 21.
I agree. I don't know whether they are in agreement with you or not.
I do agree.
That's why you said
that's correct, sir.
I do agree, sir.
Someone said, what did someone say? Said not correct or correct?
It's correct.
Oh, it's correct. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you. Who said is correct? The person I just spoke to now.
That's me, sir.
Who?
Nzwaki.
Nzwaki?
Yes.
Stay on this line with me, my sister. Now, what is the corresponding y value when we put 0 in the place of x in this function?
It's going to be 4, sir.
Thank you.
I agree. No.
Oh, that's a no.
Why is it a no?
Someone said no.
Why?
Oh, yeah. Okay, it's fine. Okay, it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Oh. I thought it's through a puzzle.
Okay, thank you.
Sorry. Yeah.
What did you say is the answer? Is it 4 or 5?
It's 4.
The answer is 4. Yes.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Hey. Who needed clarity about the answer?
It was me, sir.
Who? Your name, ma'am?
Mahadi.
Mahadi. Okay, thank you, Mahadi.
Sure.
Mahadi is... Don't go away. Now, Mahadi, do you see number 2?
Yes, sir.
Do you see number 2?
Number 2. Yes.
F of x equals to x squared.
Mm-hmm.
Now, here is my request to you. You see, we are many. I'm requesting you to pick a person. Anyone. You pick anyone who will tell us what we will get when we place f of negative 3 in this function f of x, which is equals to x squared.
Nzwaki, will you be able to help us?
Well, negative 3. It's going to be 9.
Yes. It's going to be 9.
Yeah.
Thank you, Nzwaki. It's going to be 9. Nzwaki, pick any person, anyone who hasn't spoken, anyone who hasn't said a word since
okay,
we just started.
I'm going to pick ZS. I think it's Zama or what. I don't know.
Who are you picking? ZS?
Yes. ZS.
ZS. Hello.
Zama.
Yebo.
Yes.
ZS.
Your name? Yes. One Zama.
Yes, Zama.
Yes.
F of 1. What will be F of 1 in the given function?
1.
Thank you, Zama. Zama, help us by picking any other person who will tell us what will we get when we put k in the place in this given function.
Dana.
Dama.
Yeah. Sorry, I only just joined, so I'm a bit lost on where we are.
Okay. Nkhari.
Who?
Nkhari.
Nkhari?
B Nkhari.
B, oh yeah. B Nkhari.
A.
Call him or her.
Nkari, be Nkari.
Yes.
Can you please solve for f of k for us?
This is the square root of k. This is the square root of k.
There's f of k and there's f of square root of k.
Yeah, f of the square root of k.
Okay, f of square root of k.
K squared.
Mary?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure, ma'am?
F of square root of k.
Yes. What will we get when we put the square root of k in the play in this function, f of x, which is equal to x squared?
Into x.
Yes. Okay, Ngari.
Yes, can sir.
Okay. Our function is f of x is equal to x squared.
Yes.
Now, what we are requesting you to do is just to put the square root of k. This is the square root of k in the place of x.
It's what k.
Is going to be?
K.
Thank you, my sister. Mhari, now yes. pick any person who will help us with the f of 1 plus t.
Maybe 1 plus 2t plus 2t.
Who is talking?
Gugu.
Gugu, what will we get when we put 1 plus t in this function, f of x equals to x squared?
We get we get 1 plus t to the power of 2. And when I simplify it, I get 1 plus 2t plus 2 squared.
Please ask them whether they agree with you or not.
Do you agree, guys?
Can you please repeat your answer, Kubi?
I will get 1 plus t to the power of 2. Then when I simplify it, I will get 1 plus 2t plus t squared.
Oh, yes, that's correct.
Do you agree with Gugu? Hello.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Gugu, please help me. Please choose any other person who will help us with f of x plus h.
Yes, I'm here. The answer will be x squared plus 2h plus h squared.
Please repeat.
It's x squared plus 2h plus h squared.
Yo, do they agree with you? Please ask them.
I disagree.
Do you guys agree with me?
No.
I disagree.
The middle term.
No.
I disagree.
Isn't it 2H?
No, it's not.
No.
It's not.
It's not.
No,
it's 2XH.
Oh, 2XH. Sorry, I forgot. I calculated while I was using the 1 plus T1. Sorry.
Well, what
X squared plus 2XH plus H squared.
Yes.
Yes, I made a mistake. Sorry.
Okay. Thank you. Who was talking?
B.S. Nojaja.
Nojaja. B.S. Nojaja. Okay. Please pick any next person for us.
I'll pick Mukhadi.
Has Mukhadi not spoken?
I think she did speak from
this. I have spoken, sir. I did speak. Yes. I'm
sorry.
Brandon Vipinar.
Brandon Dibner.
Brandon.
Sorry, can you excuse me? I'm busy driving back from work, so I'm just listening. I can't actually calculate and look at the same time. Sorry, man.
Okay, let's go for Eric Disetso then.
Eric?
Yes, sir.
How are you?
I'm fine, sir.
Do you see this function f? Do you see this function f of x is equals to 3x squared minus 2x plus 8?
Yes, sir.
In this function, please replace 0 in the place of x and tell us what you get.
No, we'll get 8, sir.
Do they agree with you? Ask them.
Guys, are you agreeing with me here?
Yes.
Yes, Eric, we agree.
Thank you, my brother.
Thank you.
They agree with you. Please pick the next person, my brother, before you go.
I'm going with Koketo.
Koketo. Koketo.
Yes.
F of negative 5. What will we get?
See. Is it 33?
33. Are you sure?
Oh, wait, no. Hold on. I'm not too sure. I think it's 73.
Is it Koketo? Please talk to them.
Am I right, guys? I don't know if I'm getting it right, if I'm doing it all wrong.
Can you please share how you got that? And
73 is wrong.
That's the correct one.
Okay, they say share how you arrived at that answer.
Okay.
What did you do step by step? We are listening.
Okay, I started the square root of negative 5 is negative 25, right?
Negative. Did you put the negative 5 inside brackets?
Yeah.
You still get negative.
Okay. What are you saying? Sorry, I can't hear you.
Please start again, my sister.
I think you get the 73 if you didn't put the negative, that negative in front of the 2x.
If I didn't put the negative in front of the 2x, so it's supposed to be positive because it's what? I'm plusing by 10.
Positive. You know what you can do, Ne? Punch in the whole thing, the way it is, and then put your minus 5 in brackets.
So I'm not using a calculator. I'm doing it like manually.
Koki, remember that negative times negative is positive.
So it's plus 10. So... Yes. Okay.
Sorry to disturb.
Yeah, sure. You can go ahead.
85 plus 8 is 93.
Yes. I agree with that answer.
Okay. Yes, that's correct.
Yeah, I also got 93.
Correct.
Okay, thank you. Okay. I also got it now.
You also got it now.
Yeah.
Your name again, man?
Koketso.
Koketso?
Yes.
Please pick the next person for us.
Okay, hold on. Let me check. Dalva. Has he been picked? Yeah, Dalva, Mark.
I can't remember.
How, Kua, Kua.
I'm here.
Okay.
I'm here. I got 147a squared minus 14a plus 8.
Please repeat, Dalva.
I got 147a squared minus 14a plus 8.
Please ask them whether they agree with you or not.
You guys agree with me.
Yes. I agree.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, Dalva.
Thank you.
Now, do you still remember the way we started when we started drawing functions or graphs? Do you still remember?
Yes.
I think yes. Is it from standard 4? Standard 5, standard 6, around there. Do you still remember?
Yes, grade 7.
Someone said, yes, thank you. How did we start?
We used a table.
We and used we got it
from a negative x up an x. Negative 2 until positive 2, and then we substituted using the rules that you gave us there.
Thank you. Hey, who just said that?
Zama.
In simple terms, we used a table of signs. We chose numbers on the left, on the negative, and numbers on the positive. And then we drew a table of signs.
Yes.
We substituted, then we got the corresponding entries. Now, without wasting your time, Zama, are you still with me?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. I'm requesting you any other person that I will talk to about what I need, what I'm about to say next. You and I have
There's Tondani here. He's asking, were we using a number line that has both negative values? I guess negative values and positive values. Were we using a number line that has both negative and positive values? That's Tondani's question.
In simple terms, here to say we're using number line. We use the numbers on the left-hand side and the numbers on the right-hand side of zero. Not a number line. The numbers that were negative to the zero and the positive numbers to the zero. That is what we used. Because once we start to talk about the number line, or alternatively, if he's using the words, those two words, number line, we chose the negative numbers on the left-hand side of zero. And then we chose the positive numbers on the right-hand side of zero. We substituted them into the given function to get the corresponding y values. I hope that clarifies what then my sister you said is then Dani.
It's Tondani.
Tondani.
Yes, it's Tondani. Sorry about that. It's Tondani.
Yes. I hope Tondani now follows based on what he asked us. My sister, before you came in, I was speaking to someone. Zama. It's a lady.
Zama.
Yes. Oh, Zama. Thank you, Zama. Thank you, Zama. Zama, I requested you to pick any other person that I need to talk to.
Tondani. Yes.
Okay. Tondani, please call Tondani for us, Zama.
Tondani?
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Oh, okay.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks, and how are you?
Good. Now, let's talk, you and I. Do you see number A?
Yes, I do see number A.
Here is my question to you. We have got these three functions, y equals to x, y equals to 2x, and y equals to 3x. The only thing that I'm requesting you to do is just to explain to us how they will be related on the same Cartesian plane. Do you get me?
I do get you.
I know, sir.
Do you get me?
Yes, I do get you.
On the same system of axes, when we draw them, how are they going to look compared to each other? Okay, Tondani.
I think since they are all straight line graphs and they all have the positive gradient. Okay. So I think that they're all the y-intercept is for all of them is going to be zero, if I'm not mistaken.
I agree with you.
Yes. So they are all going to fall on the positive gradient of the Cartesian plane.
I agree.
Whereby the y-intercept for each of them is going to be zero. That's what I can say.
And the x-intercept?
The x-intercept.
Okay.
Zero.
That's Tondani, ne?
Yes.
Okay, Tondani, let me help you out here. Let's start with the first one. We know that y equals to x is moving from the first quadrant into the third quadrant because the gradient is positive. Do we agree?
Yes.
Hmm?
Yes, I do agree.
Thank you. Now, if you and I agree, I'm trying to simplify my question to you. Okay, now, how will y equals to 2x? Okay. Let me rephrase my question. We agree on y equals to x. It has got a positive gradient. It's running from the first quadrant into the third quadrant. We agree, ne?
Yes.
About what I just said. Now, I'm requesting you to explain how will y equals to 2x
move
and y equals to 3x. How will I be able, drawing all these on the very same system of x's, as well as y equals to x, how will we be able to tell that this one is y equals to 2x, this one is y equals to 3x?
I'm not so sure. Because they all have the same gradient and they are all going to pass through zero.
I agree. There I agree with
you. For both x-intercept and y-intercept.
I agree with you.
Yeah, so I'm not sure how we're going to differentiate them. Unless if there's somebody who can assist me.
Big Amy.
Julian.
Julian.
And his hand was up. He'll somehow ask his question.
Julian, thank you, my sister. Julian. Julian. Don't I please call Julian for us?
Julian is... Julian, please don't be shy. Can I choose somebody else? Julian says that I have a problem with the microphone.
Okay, Dondine, please pick another person.
Okay. I'll pick Iratile.
Who?
Iratile Malapane.
Okay. Iratile. Please call her. Call him or her.
Kiratile Marapani, can you please join us on the call? Please unmute your mic.
Don't I just become surprised when people just join and decide to keep quiet.
Okay, sir, please. Can I attend?
Someone is talking. Who's talking?
Mzwagi.
Mzwagi?
Yes, sir. I want to try. I'm not sure, okay. But I want to try.
Yes, my sister.
I think that the first graph, y equals to x, will be different from the second one in terms of the second one will be on a higher scale than the y equals to x. So with each graph, there's going to be an increase in the y, I think.
That's in Swagin,
yes, sir. I think I'm not sure.
Okay, in Swagin. Thank you. This is what, okay.
Can I try? You and I, sorry.
Swagin, there is no disagreement about y equals to x.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, let's start with the next one, y equals to 2x. What I'm maybe, okay, let me rephrase my question, maybe if you are getting confused. Okay, Mzwaki, we agree that y equals to x is running from the first quadrant into the third quadrant. We agree, ne?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, we drew y equals to x. The next thing that we need to do on the very same set of x's, we need to draw y equals to 2x. Now,
yes, sir.
What I'm requesting is to say, is to find out whether this y equals to 2x in the first quadrant, how is it going to sit? Is it going to be on the left hand side or on the right hand side of y equals to x in the first quadrant?
Can I try?
It's filled, I'm interested in the positions of these. Oh.
I think it's going to be on the left-hand side, sir.
You think it's going to be on the left-hand side?
Can I try?
Sorry?
Yes, sir. I think it's going to be on the left-hand side.
And then in the third quadrant?
In the first quadrant.
I agree. On you said on the first in the first quadrant is going to be on the left.
Yes.
And then in the third quadrant, how is it going to be related to y equals to x?
I'm not sure.
Yes, please.
Yes.
So, I think it's the greater the gradient, the steeper the slope. So mm-hmm. 2 will be on the left side, and then on the third quadrant, it will be on the right.
Thank you, my sister. Thank you. Who's talking?
Zama.
Zama. Zama, please help us with the last one. How is it going to be in relation to these other two, those first two?
Okay, it's going to be on the left, mm-hmm. on the first quadrant, which is will be the first graph on the left.
Mm-hmm.
And then on the third quadrant on the right, the last side. Like, yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, Zama. That's what I needed. Please ask them whether they understand what you just said.
Do you guys understand?
I'm confused a bit with the quadrants. I'm not sure which one is 1, 2, 3, or 4. So okay. I think that's my problem, yeah.
You say you are confused about the quadrants.
Yes, which one is the first, which one is the second? Because I know on the Cartesian plane is divided into four. So yes. I'm confused with the quadrants, which one is the first one, the second one, third one, and the fourth one, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
All right, Ntswaki, don't worry. Look at the screen of your machine. Are you looking at the screen? Ntswaki?
Yes, sir, I'm looking at the screen.
Look at the screen. Lift your right hand.
Yes, sir.
Move it from the top to the bottom in the middle of the screen.
Yes, sir.
Did you move it from the top to the bottom?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. That means now you drew the y-axis, okay?
Yes, sir.
Now go to the middle of the screen.
Yes, sir.
Go to the right of the screen. Now, do you see number B?
Yes.
Please explain to us how these three functions will be related to each other on the same system of axis.
Their slope is negative, and then y is zero. So in terms of, you mean how are they going to be on the Cartesian plane?
Yes. We agree with you on everything that you said up to so far. How will they be related to each other in the Cartesian plane?
Sir, I'm not sure. You mean on the graph?
The graphs, how will the graphs?
I think they will all cross in the second Cartesian plane. I mean, in the second quadrant.
To where?
Okay, if the slope is negative, I think it will pass from the one, I mean, the first to the fourth.
Violet.
Sir?
Slowly, please. Don't confuse us. Okay? We are listening.
Okay. I think they will all, like the graphs, they will all pass from the, like from, the line will be from the first quadrant to the fourth quadrant, all passing on the negative x-axis.
I disagree. You are now talking about the vertical line.
Sorry, sir. Can I try?
Who's talking?
Itumele.
Yes, Itumele. Please go ahead.
You said you wanted to know what relationship all the graphs here will have if drawn on the same set of axes.
On the same system of axes, yes.
Okay, now I say that they all pass or touch the Cartesian plane at one point, which is zero.
I agree.
Yes.
Is that all?
That's what I know.
We are not done. We need to know how, on the very same system of axes, how will they be related to each other? How will I be able to tell that, okay, this is the graph of y equals to negative x?
And they have different slopes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. They've got different slopes, I agree with you. Now, how are they going to be sitting? How will I be able to tell that, okay, this one is this graph, this one is this one, this one is this one? That is the explanation that I need.
The way that they slant on the Cartesian plane, the slopes are different, so you can tell.
I can tell, but I'm asking you to tell me. I agree with you. Please tell us.
So I get like they have different slopes. So this one will be more slanted, the other one will be... Oh, okay. Let me put it this way. Other ones will be getting closer to the vertical plane. Than the others.
Your name again, ma'am.
Itumele.
Itumele, please don't confuse us.
There's Kayla, her hand was up and she wrote in the chat. I think she wants to help. Kayla.
Okay, Idumele, let's ask Kayla to help. Kayla, please help us. Thank you, my sister.
Hi there, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, Kayla.
Okay, so if I'm understanding correctly, sorry, I started a bit late. I had another class. Basically, as I understand it, the table or the way you will know where which is which is as y is vertical and x is horizontal, and your quadrants are clockwise working from the right to the left, you will see that y will start at zero and x being x unknown, you'll start at zero and it will work down because you're getting less and less from the center point to the left side, but in the third quadrant, and not the fourth, as y is an unknown at zero. I'm not sure if I'm right, that's what I understand.
Okay, Kayla, from what you just said, even though you are breaking, somehow we agree that these three functions are moving from the second quadrant to the fourth.
Yes.
Now, no problem with the first one. How will this, how will I tell between these two, y equals to minus 2x and y equals to minus 3x? How will they be related?
Oh, they will be going down in a straight line.
I agree. They are all straight lines. Now I
you want an expression.
I want to be to can be able to tell that okay, this one is the minus 2x. This is the minus 3x. That is what I'm requesting you to explain to us. Yes, your name, ma'am?
It's Violet again.
Violet. Thank you, Kayla. Violet, please come forward.
The y equals to minus x will be the first one that crosses the first one, and then the y equals to minus 2x will be the second one that will be on top of the yx, the first one, right? Crossing the positive y-axis and the negative y-axis. Can I stop there and then ask if I'm correct before I continue?
Are you saying in the second quadrant, the negative 2x will be
crossing the positive y-axis and the positive x-axis, and then below it will be the one y equals to minus x, crossing the negative x-axis and the negative y-axis.
Okay, so hang on there. I hear you, my sister, in the second quadrant. Now in the fourth quadrant, how is it going to be? Is it going to be above y equals to negative x or below?
It's going to be above. You mean which one is going to be above? Like, to clarify, which one are you saying is going to be above? The one y equals to minus 2x?
Yes. Is y equals to negative 2x going to be above y equals to minus x or below it in the fourth quadrant?
It's going to be above. Sir?
Hello?
It's wrong. Is it wrong?
No.
They can still help.
Your name again, ma'am?
Violet.
Ellen.
Violet.
Oh, Violet. Oh, now, Violet?
Yes, sir.
Are you, from where you are sitting, are you able to see anyone who is willing to help without us speaking? Yes, no?
No.
Okay, thank you.
From my side, if you substitute, like what I said in the chat there, if you substitute zero into all of that, that means everything's going to cross through zero, which in the middle. And if you substitute minus one into y and minus one into x, you're going to go from quadrant four to quadrant two. And if you substitute one into y, and one into x, then you're going to get into the other quadrant. So, and then the relationship between the three is the angle of the slope through the center from quadrant four to two. Okay, so as I was saying, if I substitute zero into y and zero into x, then I know that in all three lines will go through zero, where x and y is zero, so through the middle. And then if I substitute one into y and one into x, minus x, we know that that'll start on one quadrant two to quadrant four. And if you substitute minus one on the other side, and then you just draw the line through, because there's no limits, you can go to infinity on the line.
Okay, Brendan, I heard you. Are you done?
Yes.
Okay. Now, here is my request to you.
Yes.
To all of you. My request, during your own time, I will request you to draw all these graphs in number B. And then when we meet, you'll be able to can be in a position to can be able to tell me. We agree they're going through the origin. My interest is on y equals to minus 2x and y equals to minus 3x, how they are related to each other in relation or compared to y equals to minus x. Is that a fair request?
Yes, sir.
You use table of side. You use the table of side to draw these three on the same system of axes. And then when we meet, you just explain to me how y equals to minus 2x and y equals to minus 3x are compared to y equals to minus x. Thank you. Who can I rely on to say, to can be able to remind us about them? Are you trusted? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I believe that when we meet, then that is what we will start with. Now, can we continue? Is that simple? The table of signs will show you how they are on the very same system of axes in relation to one another.
Yes, sir, we can continue.
Okay, thank you. Finding the slope of a straight line y equals to mx plus c. Slope n y intercept of y equals to 2x minus 4y minus 7. Now, say, slope of a line containing points x1, y1, and x2, y2 is given by change in y over change in x, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. You still remember this formula?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay. As long as you do remember it, no problem. Can you then be able to tell me what the slope is of these two points, minus 2 and 6, minus 4 and 9? Change in y divided by change in x. Using this formula, m equals to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1.
It's 3 over negative 2.
Your name, ma'am?
Mtswaki.
Mtswaki, do they agree with you?
Negative 3 over 2.
Please ask them whether they agree with you or not.
Do you guys agree?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes, I agree.
Thank you, Mtswaki. Now, let's continue. All right. What should I say? Okay, you are all familiar with this, with the equation for a straight line, eh? Yes, no? Yes, no?
Yes,
sir.
Yes.
Okay. Nzwagi, please pick any person for me.
I'm gonna pick Itumeleng.
Itumeleng, you have been picked. Itumeleng, where are you?
Yes, sir, I'm here.
Okay, thank you, Itumeleng. Pick the next person for me.
Let me see. Brandon.
Who?
Brandon.
Brandon. Brandon.
Yes, I'm here.
Thank you. Now is Itumeleng, then is Brandon. Brandon, please pick the third person for me.
Let me just get rid of chats. I can't really see the people's names, but I see a Takunda, Saidi, Tanashi, Shalela.
Yeah, please call him.
Takunda.
Has
benefits. Yes, sir. I'm here.
Takunda, please keep pick for me the last person.
Zama, sir.
Zama. Please call Zama. Takunda, call Zama.
Yes.
Okay, Zama.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. In that order, remember it is Itumeleng followed by Itumeleng, Brandon, followed by Takunda, then followed by Zama. In less than a minute, Itumeleng, what is the slope for number one?
The slope for number one is 3. Positive 3.
What is it?
Positive 3.
Please ask them whether they agree with you or not.
We agree.
Agree.
Thank you. Brandon, it's your turn. The next one.
The slope for 2 is -2.
Please ask them.
Do you guys agree?
We agree. Yes.
Thank you, Brandon. The third person is Takunda. Takunda, number 3.
I'm getting
yes. Word medium, horse.
Please ask them whether they agree with you or not.
They are agreeing.
Can you please repeat his
answer? I'm getting 2.
He says he's getting 2.
I think you worked out the y-intercept and not the slope.
We are looking, Takunda, we are looking for the slope for number 3.
Oh.
Which is not equivalent. What about word big as being compared to the text elephant? True, because word big has elephant stored within that variable. Let's have a look at H. Number medium is less than and equal to number big divided by 3. Well,
I'm sorry, sir. I think I'm a bit confused with the calculation.
Slope for number 3. For
the gradient.
Gradient. Okay, hold on.
Mm-hmm. Gradient or slope?
So is it 1?
I don't know. You tell us.
Yes, it's 1.
Yes, we agree.
Okay.
We agree.
Okay. Thank you, Takunda. The last person, I think, is Zama. Zama.
Zama, the slope is 4 and the gradient is the y-intercept is -1.
We're interested in the slope. What is the slope first?
4.
Y-intercept?
Y-intercept -1.
Thank you. Do you all follow?
Yes, yes, sir.
Thank you. Can we continue?
Yes.
Thank you. Now, Zama.
Yes, sir.
You are the last person I've spoken to. Please pick any person Who are you picking?
Macado. Yes.
Yeah, Macado. Yo, hey. Yeah, wait. Hey, Zama, you want to get me fired, eh? Oh, what so is the initial? Eh? What is the initial for Macado?
That you're thinking? I can't remember.
Choose another person.
Okay. Golan, Numan.
Please call him for us.
Ha, Golan is leaving. Ha.
He left like that.
Yeah, Tima Kakula.
Call him.
Tima Kakula. Please help us. Thank you.
Tima Kakula. Team Magagula, please talk to us. Yo. I don't know. Can you hear?
Tebe Thomas.
Hello.
Oh. Ooh, that's Tabo Thomas, ne?
Yes, Terry.
Oh, Terry. Oh, Terry. Okay.
Mm.
Terry, please pick another person. Yours is number one. Terry, yours is number one. Please pick the next person for number two.
Okay. Dalva Makwakwa.
Who? Dalva.
Mm.
Please call him or her.
I'm here.
Yes, Dalva. Number two is for you. Dalva, please pick the last person.
The name.
Dalva, you should know.
Nzwaki.
Didn't we speak to Nzwaki a few minutes ago?
You Nzwaki, did.
Yes. Hey, Dalva, please pick another person. Who hasn't spoken?
Is it Museki?
Museki, please call him or eh?
Museki, are you here?
Yes, I'm around.
Thank you, Museki. The third one will be yours. We are finding the equation of a line. You're in all history, Terry. Number one, Dalva, number two, Museki, number three. You've got the slope and then you've got a point. You just tell us what is that, what is the equation for the line? Okay, let's start with Terry. Terry, for number one.
Okay. Y will be equals to can we please move on to number two, then I'll come back for number one.
Okay. Dalva, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Yes. What I'm seeing?
The equation of the line is y is equals to 7x.
Dalva, again?
Y is equals to 7x.
We're looking for the equation of a line. Yes, it's incomplete.
I would say, isn't it, we are supposed to get, because we are to get the equation of the line, we say y is equals to mx plus c.
Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So, since we are given the gradient m is equals to 2, right? And we are given the coordinates are 1 is to 7. Then we go on the equation y is equals to mx plus c.
Yes.
Then we put in place of y there, we put 7, right? So it's going to be 7 is equals to our m is 7, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then we substitute x, we put 1 then in place of x plus c, right? Then now we see we have c as an unknown, we have to solve for c.
Yes.
Right. So for now the equation is 7 is equals to 7 plus c.
Yes.
And then our c will be equals to 0.
I agree. Thank you, my
correct.
Thank now, you for the equation.
Okay.
Then now the equation will be?
The equation will be y is equals to 7x.
Thank you. Thank you, Dalva. Tere. Okay, Muzeki, are you ready for number 3?
Yes, I am.
Who is ready? Is it Muzeki?
Yes, Muzeki is ready.
Yes, Muzeki, what is the equation?
The equation will be y is equals to 3x minus 6.
Y equals to 3x minus 6.
Yes.
Please ask them whether they agree with you or not.
Are we in agreement or not?
Can you please repeat?
Y equals to 3x minus 6.
We don't agree.
No, we don't agree.
You don't agree?
Yes, we don't.
Yeah.
Okay.
Our gradient is 2. So you can rectify from that.
Muzeki, you can rectify from that. Did you hear that? Please rectify from that. Muzeki, who just advised Muzeki to rectify from that?
It's me, sir.
Your name, ma'am?
Ntswaki.
Ntswaki. Thank you, Ntswaki. Muzeki.
I'm having network. I didn't hear.
Ntswaki said.
Oh, Muzeki. I was saying that the gradient is 2, so you can rectify from that.
Okay.
Yes.
Musa, did you get it?
Yes, yes.
Yes, what did you get?
Yes, I'm working it out. Yes, I get it. 2x minus 6.
Yes.
Y is equals to 2x minus 6.
Please thank Nzwagi, my brother.
Thank you, Nzwagi. Thank you, Nzwagi. I didn't see that.
Thank you.
Okay.
Terry. We are back to number one. I think it's Terry in number one.
The equation is y is equals to negative 5x minus 13.
Please ask them whether they agree with you or not.
Does everyone agree?
Agree?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Terry, Dalva, Museki, and then even all those who gave assistance. Thank you. Can we continue?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Continue.
Now, without wasting time here, let me ask Museki. Museki?
Yes, sir.
We won't focus on all five of them. Museki, please pick two people for me who will work out number one and number two. Two people.
BS, no charge.
Who?
BS, no charge.
I think that person has already spoken. If I remember.
K. Muahi.
I'm here.
K. Moari, yes. And another one, K. Moari, number one is yours. Museki, okay, please pick the next person.
Tebe Thomas.
Please call him.
Tebe Thomas.
I was answering the previous question.
Okay, Tima Gagula.
Tima Gagula. Oh, another one, my brother.
Paulina Angelina.
Paulina Angelina.
Mafedile.
Mafedile.
Yes, I'm here.
Mafedile.
Hello.
Okay. Please help us with number two, my sister, Mafedile.
Okay.
Thank you, Musagi. We are waiting for Kemuari in number one, and then in number two, we are waiting for Mafedi.
For number one, I got my gradient is -4/7.
-4/7. Please talk to them. Ask them whether they agree with you or not.
Do you agree?
Yes, agree.
Thank you very much.
Agree.
Thank you. Matelile, we are waiting for you on number two.
Okay, our gradient is 1/4.
What is it, my sister?
1/4.
Please ask them.
Guys, do you agree?
Yes.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you, Mafedile. Now, the 3, 4, and 5, you can do them during your own time. For the sake of time, now let's move on to the next slide. Okay. We all remember a quadratic formula or a quadratic function. We say a quadratic function is given by ax squared plus bx plus c, which is equals to 0. Where a is not equals to 0. Then we say this quadratic function is a cup-shaped curve. It's not a straight line, it's a cup-shaped curve. It opens upward. So if A is greater than 0, or opens downward if A is less than 0, meaning it opens upwards if A is positive, opens downwards if A is negative. Next, it has a turning point or vertex whose first coordinate is given by -2, -b/2a. This -b/2a is the vertical line that we refer to as the symmetry, the line of symmetry, meaning that line divides the quadratic function into two equal parts. You still remember this? This is what you dealt with in high school. Can you all remember all these points that I'm sharing with you in here, in this slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Now, if you all remember them, now we are going, the next thing that we are going to do is to move into the application in the next slide. Example, we have got f of x is equals to x squared minus 2x minus a is 1, b is equals to negative 2, and c equals to negative 3. X is equals to -b/2a, which is -2/2 times a, a which is 1, then we end up having 1. Now, substituting that 1 for x, we find the second coordinate for the vertex. This is what we do. This is what we did from high school. We use the axis of symmetry equation, x equals to minus b over 2a, to find the corresponding x value for the turning point or the vertex. After finding that x value, we substitute it where in the original equation to get the corresponding y value. Now, in this case, when we substitute 1 in the given equation, we end up having negative 4. Are we still together?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Yes.
Yes.
Now, Mafedile.
I don't think he's still here.
Okay, my sister. Kemoari.
Oh, Arote, sorry.
Okay. Mafedile.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Do you see these three exercises here?
Yes.
Yes. My request is that you give me three people. The first one will give us the vertex in number one. The next one will give us the vertex for number two. The third person will give us the zeros for the last exercise. Who are you choosing as the first person to give us the vertex for number one? The advice that I can give is that the quadratic formula first has to be written in its standard form before you can continue. Gugu, are you finished?
Done.
Done, yes. Please share your answer with us for the vertex.
Vertex will be P over 3 and 4.
Please repeat, my sister. I can hardly hear you.
X will be 3 over 2 and Y will be 4.
3 over 2 and?
4.
And 4. 3 over 2 and 4. Is that what you said?
Yes, sir.
Please ask them whether they agree with you or not.
You guys agree?
Sir, can you repeat your answer?
3 over 2 and 4.
S equals to 3 over 2.
No. The vertex.
Oh,
the vertex for number one, the x coordinate is 3 over 2. And then the y coordinate is 4. The vertex or the turning point. That is what Gugu is saying. Do you agree with her or not?
No, I don't.
Who doesn't agree? Who's talking?
It's Violet.
Violet disagrees.
Maybe it's because of I don't get how you did it. I might be wrong.
Let's ask Gugu to explain. Gugu, please share with us how you arrived at this vertex, at the coordinates of the vertex.
the standard format of the equation will be, I'll take x squared to the other side. So I'll get x squared plus x squared minus 3x.
Please repeat, Google.
I'll get y equals 2 minus x squared minus 3x plus 10.
Okay.
Then add the x value for the vertex. I will use the formula minus t over 3.
I agree with you on that one. And then next.
So my A is negative 1, my B is negative 3, and my C is 10.
Mm-hmm.
And I will substitute negative bracket negative 3 over 2 times 1.
Google.
So, I think
I got it wrong. Someone is talking. Google, can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, sir.
I agree with you on the axis of symmetry, the 3/2. I'm in agreement with you, okay? Would you please repeat how you got the corresponding y value of this turning point?
I substituted the x into the equation.
You substituted 3/2 into the original equation.
Yes, sir. But it's wrong. The x must be near to 3/2, then you substitute the equation to get the y.
So if that is the case, that means you had y is equals to minus 9/4, eh?
Yeah, I think this.
Are we together, Google?
Yes, sir.
The first entry is minus 9/4, eh? Hmm? The first term.
Yes.
Then the next one is okay, let's see.
Oh.
The first one is minus 9/4. Then the next one is minus 9/2. Do we agree?
Yes, sir.
Plus 10. Do we agree, Google?
Yes, I got minus 2/2 and 16.
Sorry?
X value will be 3, minus 3/2. And then the y value is 16 for the text.
Google, what will be the? I agree with you on the x value.
It's negative 2/2, not 2/2. I made a mistake.
Okay, let's start. Our formula. You have got x squared, ne?
Okay.
It's equals to 10 minus 3x. Now our formula will be equals to minus x squared minus 3x plus 10. Do we agree?
Yes.
Now our axis of symmetry is minus b/2a. So this is minus into minus 3 over 2 times minus 1. So our axis of symmetry is minus 3 over 2. Do we agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you agree. You and I are agreeing on something. Now from there, we take this minus 3 over 2. We are going to substitute it away in the original equation. Then we'll have y is equals to minus into minus 3 over 2, everything squared, minus 3 times open bracket, minus 3 over 2 plus 10. Are we still together, Google?
Yes, sir.
Now, the next thing that we'll need to do, this will be negative 9 over 4, the first term. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Then plus 9 over 2 is the next term. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Then plus 10. Now we are going to add these three terms. Our LCM here is 4. Now we have got minus 9. 2 into 4 goes 2 times. Then times 2 times 9. 2 times 9 is 18. Plus 1 into 4 is 4. 4 times 10, that's 40. Now we have got 18 minus 9 is 9, so this is 9. This is 49 over 4. Do we agree? As the turning point, the corresponding y value. Do we agree? Google?
Yeah. Yes, I do.
You and I agree that for the vertex, the x value is minus 3 over 2. Do we agree?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, the y value for the turning point is positive 49 over 4. Do we agree?
Yes, sir, I do agree.
Okay. Thank you. Who was working out number 2? Is there anyone who was working out number 2?
I was. Oh, Melo.
Melo Kuhle, ne?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Melo Kuhle.
It's 1 and negative 25.
1 and negative 25.
Yes, sir.
Please ask them whether they agree with you or not.
Do you guys agree?
I agree.
There is an agreement. Thank you, Melo Kuhle. Can we continue? People, are you still here with me?
Yes.
All right. Thank you. Now, the next thing that we need, I'm interested in talking to you about, is for any non-zero real number A and any integers N and M. This is coming from that section of the exponents from your high school. Number A, we are saying A to the power N times A to the power M. We use that exponential law that says when we multiply in exponents, when we've got the same basis, we add the exponents. You still remember?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In number B, the bases are the same, but we are dividing. Now we are subtracting. Still remember that?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
In number C is a base raised to a power and everything raised to that power. So that power is meaning in this case, the powers are multiplied together. That's number
yes.
C.
Yes, sir.
Now, number D is A to the power negative an exponent is the same as 1 over A to the, that exponent being positive. You still remember?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Now, do we agree that A to the power 5 over 3 is the same as 32?
Yes, sir.
Anyone who disagrees? All right. 81 to the power 3 over 4. Do we agree that?
Yes, sir.
At the end is equals to 3 cubed. 81 to the power 3 over 4 is the same as 81 to the power 1 over 4. Everything to the power 3 end up being yes, 3 sir. Cubed, which gives us 27.
Yes, sir.
All right. Thank you. Now, here is my request to you to simplify these 5 exercises. During your own time at home, when you are relaxed, these are just some of the exercises that you can just practice, use them to practice. Okay. Then, I'm very much concerned. I'm worried.
There's another hand. And Lugo Giorgio. Lugo Giorgio. Sorry if I pronounce your surname wrong.
It's okay. It's Ndluko Jolo. Good evening, everybody. Sorry to interrupt you guys, right? I do have a question for Mr. Dlane regarding the quadratic equations and finding the zeros, because I don't think he addressed that tonight. So I'm like kind of uncomfortable moving forward without like understanding it fully. Thank you.
Ma'am, I hear you. And then we are here. I'm happy that you were here. How did you then? Because I asked people to help us work out this. People just quiet, didn't want to participate. That's why I said, then this one, you'll just do it at your own time. I agree that I didn't talk much about that based on the reason that I just mentioned. People, I really don't know. Help me out. Let me step off this light. Let me come here. Help me out. Ma'am Lugo Jolo, this is the implication of you people not wanting to participate. Your word, maybe your advice to us, to everybody, how should we deal with this situation?
I think I agree with, I think it was Ntswaki who said that move with those who are moving with you. And I think you also need to consider the fact that we all don't learn in the same way. So some of us, I know I'm speaking for myself, I'm comfortable learning quietly in my own space while listening to you teach. Others are more confident engaging and interacting with you. But I think the fact that we are here attending the class and engaging in the comment section should tell you that we are present. So I don't know, but I agree with, I think it was Nzaki, the first speaker, who said that move with those who are moving with you. And for those who don't engage but are still moving with you, I think they will ask questions at a later stage, because I don't think it's fair for you to expect everyone to engage with you in a similar way to Violet, Nzaki, and I think Itumeleng and other people who've been engaging with you yesterday and today. So I agree with Nzaki, just move with the people that are moving with you. And then those who have questions regarding the lesson that you have, maybe then you can talk to them on the side, because at the end of the day, I think it's going to be pointless if you want everyone to engage, but no one is really taking in anything, because we don't learn the same. So that's all I have to say, honestly. We do appreciate this, but like, I feel like also just consider that we are not the same. Some of us are not even comfortable speaking on these platforms, but we are attending. The fact that we took time, like the 2 hours that we took to attend the class, should be enough. And the rest will be from us. Yeah, that's all I have to say.
I agree and disagree with you. For the fact that you join the session, from where I'm sitting, I'm expecting people to engage. I'm not expecting people to come here and just keep quiet. That one is a no-no for me. My request again, please, let's all engage. That's my plea to all of you. Now, let me lastly go to that slide that you asked me about. Remember from high school, in order to find the x-intercept of a quadratic formula, we let y to be equals to zero.
Yes.
Then from there, we get the factors. Let's take this example, 3x squared minus 4x minus 2. F of x is considered to be y. Then from there, the x-intercept or the zeros will be given by 3x squared minus 4x minus 2. Now, those two brackets that we need, the first factor in the first bracket will be 3x. The first factor in the second bracket, it will be x.
Yes.
Now, let's see. This is how we were taught. Like in this case, we've got 3x squared minus 4x minus 2. We're looking for the factors of 3x squared and the factors of minus 2. Now we consider the sides. The middle term, which is 4x, has got a negative sign. That sign is telling us that we are going to have different signs for those factors, but the one which is bigger is going to take the negative sign. But then in this case, the factors for 2 are 2 and 1. That means another one, it will be negative 2 and another one will be positive 1. But now, let's test whether 3x minus 2n x plus 1 are indeed the factors of 3x squared minus 4x minus 2. Now, how do we test that? We multiply them out. If we multiply them out, they must give us this very same thing that we've been given. So now we'll have 3x squared plus 3x minus 2x minus 2. Now, positive 3x and minus 2x are giving us what? Plus x. Do we agree? They are not giving us minus 4x, which is the middle term. Are we together?
Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
That means, let's see, if we move them around, first bracket, the first term, it will still be 3x. In the next bracket, the first term will still be x. Now let's see. Now we've got plus 1, 3x plus 1, and then we've got negative 2 in the next bracket. Let's see. Multiply out, we've got 3x squared. Now we'll have minus 6x. Now we'll have plus x. Then we'll have minus 2. The sum of these two terms is now giving minus 5x. We are not looking for minus 5x. We are looking for minus 4x.
Yes.
That means that we need to use a quadratic formula to solve this quadratic equation. Still remember the quadratic formula?
Yes.
Do you still remember the quadratic formula?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Under this situation, under this circumstance, that's where the quadratic formula comes to our rescue. So the quadratic formula will have to be used to find the zeros of this quadratic equation. Ma'am, have I assisted you?
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you. The next thing that we are going to talk about when we meet, we are going to start to talk about introduction to the concept of a limit. We are going to start to talk about limits. Okay? This you can work out during your own time, and then this is the end for today. That's why I'm saying to you, next time when we meet, we'll start to talk about limits.
Yesterday you gave us homework.
Yes.
Yes, while I was trying to attempt the homework, I'm a bit confused a little. Do these subscripts say, I get it, let me give you the first one, the first linear systems, right? We have row 1, 3x, and then subscript 1 minus 2x subscript 2. Do those, what do they mean?
I also had a problem with that because I couldn't understand what the subscript meant. So I don't know if maybe you can, because on one-on-one about tomorrow, I can't make it mean tomorrow. So I was also asking like for clarity on that.
We will talk during our next session when we'll be dealing with those questions.
Okay.
Is it okay?
Yes.
All right. On that note, can we call it a night?
Yes.